The long-awaited Loomis bill to regulate cryptocurrencies has been withdrawn from consideration. CoinDesk reports that on Tuesday, Senator Cynthia Loomis of the Republican Party and Kirsten Gillibrand of the Democratic Party introduced a crypto bill that would have far-reaching implications. Both Loomis and Gillibrand have shown interest in seeing the United States government enact a comprehensive set of rules covering all aspects of digital assets. The law will cover everything, beginning with explicit definitions of some of the phrases that are frequently confused with one another in a digital assets arena. In addition to this benefit, it would ensure that investors from the United States are exempt from paying taxes on purchases of less than $200 worth of goods and services. In addition to that, it would provide the Commodity Futures Trading Commission with certain brand new authorities. Gillibrand is a member of the Agriculture Committee, which is responsible for monitoring CFTC and commodities, while Loomis is a member of the Banking Committee, which is responsible for monitoring the Securities and Exchange Commission. Therefore, the Responsible Financial Innovation Act may genuinely have a chance of overcoming the many obstacles that lie in its path. Charles Hawkinson, the founder of the Cardano blockchain and one of the most prominent figures in the cryptocurrency sector, has provided his response to the new regulation. Hawkinson is of the opinion that we may be getting closer to a time when the United States of America will have the best cryptocurrency regulation in the world. He believes this could be the case as a result of a wide-ranging bipartisan bill, as well as a general change in attitude towards the crypto industry in Washington. As a consequence of this, Hawkinson anticipates that the cryptocurrency industry will very soon be flooded with an enormous amount of new capital. Welcome to Smart Stock Academy, where you'll discover videos about businesses and insights from your prominent CEOs. Thank you for joining us for today's video, and let's explore topics that will awaken your curiosity when it comes to stocks and investments. Make sure to like, share, subscribe, and click that notification bell to assure you that you'll be updated whenever we upload videos.
If you look at CoinDesk, you'll see this Responsible Financial Innovation Act has dropped from Senators Gillibrand and Cynthia Loomis. Cynthia is one of my senators in Wyoming, and she is known to be a great crypto advocate and has for a long time been a big fan of our industry. But of course, as a lawmaker, has a responsibility and moral obligation to make sure that the industry is well regulated. So she's been working for quite a bit of time and trying to understand what's the best approach to regulate the crypto industry in a way that protects consumers but doesn't disrupt the marketplaces or favor one actor over another actor or promotes regulation through enforcement. Where instead of we all know the rules are unclear, and then it's whoever gets hit by the watchdog is the loser of the year, which is what's been going on right now. So she's working with Kirsten Gillibrand, who's a Democratic senator from the state of New York, and her office, Loomis's office, reached out to us, I believe, in December of last year, and we've had numerous conversations, and I know that they've had numerous conversations with tons of leaders in the cryptocurrency space. And they put together a comprehensive piece of legislation. So here's the summary of it. It's about 6 pages, the summary, and the whole bill is quite large. The copies that we got were over 140 pages. And when we saw them, actually just a few weeks ago when we were in DC, it was still growing and still changing. But it covers all kinds of things. So Title I covers definitions, Title II, responsible tax for digital assets, different sections, de minimis exclusions, broker clarifications, trading safe harbor for non-US persons, decentralized autonomous organizations, digital asset lending agreements, IRS guidance, RIA guidance. You have digital asset mining and staking guidance. Then there's conforming amendments. Then there's stuff on the security side, and it creates a lot of legal classifications. And what they do is they basically kind of talk about the Howey test. And they talk about its relationship to commodities. And basically what they do is they create a situation where things that are obviously a commodity ought to be a commodity, and things that are behaving like securities should be securities. So it's not saying nothing is a security or nothing is a commodity, but it kind of clarifies this a little bit in section 301, 302, 303, 304, and so forth. Then under Title IV, covers commodity innovation. So it gives a lot of definitions. There's a lot of jurisdictional considerations. And they actually reference one of my favorite bills, H.R. 7614. And that's this bill right here, which actually is the Digital Commodity Exchange Act, which again is a big step forward in innovation and how one would regulate a cryptocurrency. So there's a bunch of stuff for payment stable coins. And it says, by the way, if you claim to be asset-backed, then you really need to make sure that you're asset-backed. And there needs to be checks and balances there because you're in a position of trust. You're not a full cryptocurrency. Your only reason you're valuable is people trust that you do something and they can't see that with the code. Then they put in a consumer protection issue, payments innovation section, and banking innovation section. Some studies are here and certain Federal Reserve services and other things. And then there's an interagency coordination, including a sandbox guidance and estate money transmission law modernization, all kinds of stuff here, cybersecurity standards for digital asset intermediaries. And it's just been a joy talking to their office and learning from them and engaging with them. I get the sense that Senator Lummis, first, she's a great leader, and I really enjoy all the people that they have. And Gillibrand has been nothing but kind. But more importantly, I think there's a very strong desire to actually solve the problem. It's not a perfect bill. There's a lot of things that need to be discussed, worked out. And the reality is that I think there's going to be a convergence of forces. So this bill combined with Biden's executive order, the things that will come out of that working group are probably going to smash into each other. And there's going to be a big, massive discussion in the industry as a whole. And I think what's going to end up happening is through iterations, the industry is going to converge to kind of a canonical bill. And then it's just a question of how the hell do we get that thing passed? And if we get it passed, it will give us the clarity that we need as an industry to really stabilize everything. And it'll still take care of bad actors. And there's certain things I care a lot about. Like, I really want a cryptocurrency user's consumer bill of rights. I really care about a definition of decentralization so we can actually get to sufficiently decentralized. And also, there's a lot of transnational discussions that need to be had about algorithmic law and algorithmic compliance and so forth. But this is a massive step forward. And frankly, it's an example of where Washington actually did listen to the industry and engage with people. And it didn't bias it towards one crazy standard or another. And a lobbyist hasn't gotten hold of it and turned it into some toxic monster that only benefits one actor over another. It's unlikely in its current form to pass. It has to go through four different committees. And that's very, very hard. Obviously, there's going to be a lot of conversations, a lot of work behind the scenes to see what's necessary there. And it's unknown whether the executive branch fully supports this or not. But I do know that there's been conversations between the legislative and executive branch. But I do believe they're waiting for their clarity to come before they have an official position. But what's nice is this creates a foundation upon which we all can read and talk. And if you take a look at the links in this video, or just Google the bill name, or take a look at CoinDesk article, you can read it yourself and have your own opinion. And my hope is over the next 12, 24 months, if we all work together, I think we can get to a point where we finally get something passed and then it's done. We actually have a foundation of regulation that's not intrusive, and it allows us to innovate as an industry and be able to build great things as an industry. So it's a thank you to the leadership of Lummis's office and all the people that have been working and support her. I know there's a lot of heroes to get this over the hump, like Tyler Lindholm and many others. And it was a lot of work on their part. Do not underestimate the amount of conversations that they've had and the difficult back and forth that they've had and how many lawyers they've had to deal with and very technical issues. And certainly a lot of conversations with the SEC and CFTC and so forth. And it is now the end of the beginning. There will be some bill that gets passed, if not in this House and Congress, then in another one, but some bill will pass at some point. It depends on the politics, and we'll just see how things go. But we as citizens supposedly are in control of our government, so we have to let our voice be heard and let our voice be known that regulation through enforcement is a terrible precedent and systemically damaging to the industry. You need to have the legislative branch do its job and create the frameworks necessary for us as entrepreneurs to click into. nothing in this bill would be difficult for me as a company to do anything. We're a software developer. And there's plenty of things that would make our lives a lot easier and make the industry's lives a lot easier and stop costing jobs and innovation to other people. I do think that different bodies need to step up and get highly involved. Like I've been a big fan of the Commerce Department getting involved and standards being created through NIST and NSF programs being used to create big subsidies for foundational research in the space. But all things considered, I'm pretty happy today. And I'm excited to see that Lemus's staff, I think, are going to be at Consensus and doing some presentations there. And then we as an industry now have to show up because they showed up. We asked the lawmakers to come and give us their best ideas. And now it's our job as an industry to go up and read these things and really go deep and have a great conversation.
The Secretary of the Treasury, Janet Yellen, was also quoted as saying that appropriate legislation needs to be created for the cryptocurrency market before the end of the year. Additionally, nations such as the United Arab Emirates and Japan are making enormous strides with regard to digital assets, which means that there are a great deal of incentives for the executive and legislative branches of the United States government to really glance into the crypto world and get some actual work done. That's it for today's video. Let us know what you think and leave it in the comments section so we'll know what your insights are. Again, make sure to like, share, subscribe, and click that notification bell for more updated videos about the business world.